a brighter day. Even though I want to leave, I have to stay here in the night where I live my life. Here in the night where I try to hide. Here in the night, living in shadowland. Here in the night, I'm such a lonely man. But if only images
song called We Should Be Dancing.
Oh,
Thank you. These last couple songs we just did were not really meant to be feed the world type songs as much as they were songs that we want to make you guys look at the indifference in your own life and in our lives. Because a lot of times it's easy to say we want to help and we want to do things, but we don't shed any tears over it. We don't really feel it. Feeding the world right now is a fad. It's a fad and a fashion, and people are cashing in on it. I want to tell you guys one thing. People have been starving to death a lot longer than Michael Jackson has been singing We Are the World. And they're going to continue to do so unless we ourselves get the indifference out of our lives and start shedding some tears and start getting on our face before God and doing something about it. It's up to us. This is a new song. It's called Tears Don't Fall.
1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Thank you. A lot of times we set goals for ourselves. We have different things that we want to achieve in life. And that's not bad at all. It's good to have those kind of dreams. It's good to plan. It's good to know what you want to do with yourself. But a lot of times we get wrapped up in those things so much that we forget about Christ in our lives and what God wants us to do and how that he fits into the whole situation. It gets confusing. It gets confusing a lot of times, and we don't know what to do, and we feel like we're being locked in, and we feel like that no doors are being opened or nothing's happening. And we have all these things we want to achieve, and we wonder why that God isn't allowing us to do that. And I'll tell you, a lot of the times, it's not because he doesn't want us to do those things. It's just because he wants us to put him first in our lives. He wants us to make him the priority, and then all the other things are going to fall into place. This is a song about that. It's called Dreams. A while back, I was out to dinner with a friend, and we were talking about some different things, and all of a sudden, she told me, she says, you know, the one thing that I want to do more than anything in this world is to see Christ. She said, if I could only see him. You know, she says, sometimes my faith grows weak, and sometimes I just get frustrated because I can't reach out and I can't grab him, and sometimes it's hard. Sometimes it's hard to hold on to believing in a God that we can't see or feel. And she said, if I could just see him, you know, if I could just touch him. And I read her a scripture out of Revelation's 21st chapter. It's talking about when we go to be with Christ. It says that there won't be any more sorrow, any more heartache, no more tears. We're going to go. And this is a song of praise about that day. It's called A Million Years. If you want to sing along with this, go ahead.
Thank you.
stars, a million years.
A million years to be with you. A million years and more.
Come on, you guys, one more time. A million years.
A million years to be with you. A million years and more.
You guys, we're going to play a couple more songs and then someone's going to come up and talk for a minute. Stick around. We'll be here after if you guys want to talk to us about anything. We'll be here, so feel free to come up. And we'd like to thank you guys for letting us play tonight. I want you to sing this chorus with us. It's called We Live Forever. It goes like this.
We're going to live forever. That's what Jesus said.
We're gonna live forever.
We're gonna live forever. That's what Jesus said. We're gonna live forever. That's what Jesus said.
Sing it with us. We're gonna live forever.
Jesus said, we're gonna live forever. That's what Jesus said.
Sing it again. We're gonna live forever.
We're gonna live forever. That's what Jesus said.